IGDP is an inter-college graduate program. And the idea is that instead of the graduate program being housed in one department, it is spread across multiple departments. The PhD program started in the 70s. It started with the artificial heart program originally. There's even a device out on the market called the Lion Heart.
As a graduate student, I was given a great deal of opportunities to mentor and train and work with undergraduate students. They all came from different backgrounds, not just from biomedical engineering, but also from chemical engineering and other life science majors. And you not only mentor and train them, but at the same time, you learn a lot from teaching these students.
One thing that makes me really enthusiastic about the IGDP program is the opportunity to work on interdisciplinary research. So coming from a background in engineering, it's really nice to have all of these new applications in biology to make good use of my skill set.
What really appealed to me about the grad program here at Penn State was the clinical ties that a lot of the research labs have. We have a lot of close working projects with a lot of people down at the Hershey Medical Center. That was really important to me. I like to actually see that there's, you know, a problem out there that our research is directly helping to solve.
I actually have two advisors and I also have a collaborator at Hershey Medical Center. So I was able to work with different mentors from different backgrounds, and I think it's really great because you learn about molecular biology from one person, you learn about material science from another professor. I think at Penn State, you know, you have all these experts from different backgrounds, and it will only make you grow as a researcher and a scientist.
Historically in bioengineering, one of the contributions that the discipline has is building tools or instruments to do new experiments. There's a student who is building his own microscope from the bottom up, so starting with the microscope objectives and buying mirrors and lenses and a table, and that has come together and allowed for incredible jump in resolution.
So my research is focused on pediatric ventricular assist device. So a ventricular assist device is basically a heart pump for a patient who has born with a congenital heart defect. We're working on actual medical devices that are in production, being implanted in patients every day.
My research at Penn State is about using immune cells to fight against different cancers. I know that the project that I'm currently working with, for example, my brain cancer project, developing drug delivery system for brain cancer, it'll eventually have a huge impact on the patients' lives. Just giving an opportunity for these students to be exposed to biomedical engineering, it's really a meaningful activity that I think graduate students can do.
I was really drawn to Penn State from just the number of opportunities that are available. So coming in here, I could get a good idea of what type of research I can get into and how that could expand out. One thing that you have to keep in mind is, where do you want to be 5 years from now and 10 years from now? And what type of skill set do you have now, and what do you want to build towards?